أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. All praises due to Allah, peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. سئل سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه عن التقوى سأله رجل ما هي التقوى فقال هل أخذت طريقا ذا شوك قال نعم قال فماذا صنعت قال إذا رأيت الشوك عدلت عنه أو جاوزته أو يعني ابتعدت عنه أو قصرت عنه فقال فذاك التقوى يعني هذه هي التقوى. هذا مثال. سيدنا أبو هريرة يالله be pleased with him. Once he was asked, what is taqwa? What does the word taqwa mean? The concept of taqwa. He replied a man and he said, he replied him actually in a practical way. He gave him an example. He said, have you ever walked on a thorny pathway? He said, yes. And then he said, how do you do that? He said, whenever I find a thorn, I just cross over. I try to avoid it. I try to get away from it, to move away from it. Sayyidina Abu Huraira said, this is exactly what taqwa means. When you find a place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is disobeyed, and when people are just, you know, committing sins, move away from this place. If you have a friend that once in a while they try to push you to do something bad or to commit a mistake, just keep away from him. The meaning, the word of taqwa means is to try to be away from the causes and the reasons of committing sins. This is how you really approve that you are watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, the word taqwa is a very wide meaning and it has so many definitions. But this example, when it tried to give people a practical example, it gives a lot of sense and a lot of meaning to understand that if we are walking in a place that we cannot step over something that might harm our foot, we try, by default, we try to move away from it. This is taqwa. Any place and anywhere and any reason where that you find yourself is pulled to commit a mistake or to, you know, to do sins or to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just move away from this and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reason why we always recite إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. We seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek assistance and aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But in the meanwhile, we need also to utilize the means to do our role and to try our best to keep away from anything that, you know, take us away from the concept of taqwa and being watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نسأل الله العليم الحكيم الخبير أن يلطف بنا وبالمسلمين في كل مكان وأن يلهمنا وإياكم التقوى والرشد وحسن العمل وحسن الخاتمة وجزاكم الله خيرا وصبحكم الله بالخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.